Hi, and welcome back to the Big Dog Acoustic Guitar Series. Hey, this is your very first 1 minute riff challenge, and this is going to be between the E minor and the A minor. Now, here's what I'm going to have you do. Not only are you going to do the riffs like that, I'm going to have you do the riffs with accent strumming together. Because when you're doing the riffs, what you're going to learn now is that you're going to do the riffs while you're doing the strumming. And here's what I'm talking about. Your strumming pattern that I'm going to have for you, and it's a simple little riff. I'll put the tab up there for you. It's going to go like this. Go to your A minor. Whoops. Okay, and I'll get that up close for you. But here's what I want you to do. When you're strumming, your strumming pattern is going to be like this. One and two and three and four. But we're not just going to strum like that. We're going to be lifting up our fingers. For instance, on the A minor, it'll be like this. See how much different that is instead of just like this? One. That's your beat that you want to do. And here's what's going to be tricky for you. You're going to do the riffs at the same time. So it'd be like this. And what I'm saying, but at the same time, you don't miss a beat on your strumming. You're strumming across the strings, but you're really focusing on hitting the riff notes. Okay, so here's your accent strumming pattern that I want you to do. What you're gonna, the count is gonna be just like this. One and two and three and four. But instead of just playing A minor like that and E minor, we're gonna put accent strumming on this. And the way we're gonna do it is we're gonna lift up on your A minor. I want you to lift up your ring finger and your middle finger completely off the fretboard. And then get them back down like that. And that's that muscle memory. You're still working on that muscle memory. Now you'll do the same thing on the E minor. It's the same two fingers that you're lifting up on this first exercise. So it should be fairly easy. It's going to be a little difficult for you, but you'll get it. You'll pick it up pretty quick. So on your E minor, the tricky part is going to be adding that riff into it without losing the strum beat. So here's what I'm talking about. Your riff, look at your riff up there. Starting off on that E minor, you go open six. And that gets into your A minor, okay? There's your A minor riff. So what I'm saying, when you're adding it with the strumming, it'd be like this. See how I'm doing that? I don't miss the strum, but I focus on hitting those strings. Watch, here we go. One more time, go back to that E minor. Okay? Now your A minor riff is like this. It goes down to the E minor. Okay, and you don't want to miss a lick on that either, so you're... That's what I want you to do. So, I mean, watch the strum beat on that, on the guitar, just like that. Okay, now we'll do that little break. here's something to remember. When you're doing those licks, you don't have to hit every string on the chord, okay? What's most important is that you're just getting some, you're not losing your strum beat. The beat stays the same, and you're hitting some of those strings to get some kind of flavor out of that chord. Because I am focusing on those bottom strings, making sure that I get those notes in. Okay, try that, and I want you to do that for a solid minute. See how many times you can get that chord and the riff in 1 minute. Hey, you don't have to report back to me. You don't have to do a test. It's all up to you to do it right and to make sure that you're the one that's getting the most out of this. All right, I'm going to go ahead and play along with you for 1 minute, and you can turn the volume down on your device if you don't want to listen to me playing, but I wanted to play along with you, and sometimes it's easier to have somebody to play with as well. So anyway, we'll start when that timer will kick down from 5 seconds, and when it starts, we'll go together. So here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and...